He is his nation's first Pacific president. So his arrival here in Vietnam, with which the US shares a painful past, is powerfully symbolic. Both countries are now rushing to make their new partnership as solid as possible before Mr. Obama completes his last term. Every neighborhood here has memorials for those who died in what they call the American War. But what matters today to this fast-growing country is trade, development, and even military cooperation to counter Vietnam's big neighbor, China.
Dealing with both China and US in order to maintain good relations with both and in order to maintain a beneficial relations with both is not easy at all.
The Americans aren't letting history stop their embrace of Vietnam as an economic and increasingly a strategic ally. But what about human rights and freedom? We've wanted to ask ordinary Vietnamese what they think about President Obama's visit, but the communist authorities have blocked us from doing that. In fact, from doing any reporting aside from the president's visit. The economic transformation of this country over the last 20 years has been remarkable, but it is still a one-party state that is as restricted and authoritarian as it's always been.
The US president's visit comes right after a general election for a largely ceremonial assembly in which Communist Party domination is guaranteed. But this year, more than 100 independent candidates tried to contest seats. Nearly all were rejected. Among them, this singer, Mai Khoi.
President Obama, I want to meet you.
She now wants to meet President Obama to ask for his help.
If the President Obama meet us, it will encourage young people care more about politics. Everything has to change, but the change in Vietnam is quite slow.
Adam was no sinner. Mai Khoi is part of a younger generation of Vietnamese who want more say in how their country's run. Their parents were content just to see an end to the long years of war and improved living standards. But the inflexible and sometimes insecure ruling party here must know that economic growth alone is no longer enough. Jonathan Head, BBC News, Hanoi.